Did you ever dream of creating a game with a realistic vegetation system? Or have you ever wondered how to achieve a shader that adds a realistic wind motion, interactive elements, local wind effects, seasonal changes, subsurface scattering, noise tint, size fade, detail blending, and more? All while ensuring reasonable performance. Well, hi everyone, it's me Aryan, and today we want to review an asset known as the Vegetation Engine, designed to handle all the aspects I mentioned and even more. The Vegetation Engine stands out as a collection of highly customizable shaders and powerful tools crafted to integrate various assets from the Unity Asset Store, Megascans, SP3, Tree Creator, and even custom models developed by your team. Compatibility is not an issue as the Vegetation Engine supports all the render pipelines. The reviews of this asset show that it is compatible with doing everything you expect without any worries. It supported a vast range of party tools and vegetation assets. Also, the documentation explains everything in detail, and the developer made great tutorials, so you can't miss anything. Thanks to the developer, I have the opportunity to review the Vegetation Engine. It's a big asset. I won't be able to cover every aspect, but let's dive into its functionality and see how it operates. After importing the assets, select the render pipeline compatible with your project and upgrade the project materials. Navigate to the demo folder where you will find various demos. Let's explore the diorama demo. You will notice the motion of the vegetation. This means that it is set up correctly. If it appears overly green, make sure to include the diffusion profile in the HDRP global settings. Explore other demos like direction, illustrating how the direction element empowers wind control. There's also an emissive demo and an explosion demo. Be sure to check out all the demos to experience and understand each functionality provided by Assist. Navigate to Window, Boxophobic, the Vegetation Engine, Shader Manager. Within this menu, you have the option to set the shader render engine, enabling instanced indirect support. The Vegetation Engine integrates with tools like GPU Instancer, Flora, Nature Renderer, and others. I managed to test with GPU Instancer, rendering 1 million trees with remarkable performance. This highlights that the Vegetation Engine minimally impacts performance. If you happen to have Amplify Shader, the developer provides a tutorial to guide you on customizing it further, unlocking the potential for even higher performance. Three main things on this asset are the Manager, Asset Converter, and Elements. Let's take a closer look at each one. In the asset, you will find a Learn Scene, open it up, and you will discover there are many prefabs here. Right-click in the hierarchy, go to Boxophobic, the Vegetation Engine, and add the Manager. The Manager is responsible for sending global data to shaders. The global motion will send the motion data to shaders. The detail settings are used to control the terrain grass and details for the terrain detail add-on. Global control controls various shading aspects such as global subsurface, noise textures, and fade settings. The global volume renders the detailing elements to render textures which are then sent to the vegetation or props shaders. And also the object scale is the bounds of the rendering. In the environment game object, we have trees, grass, and rocks. To make these presets compatible with the Vegetation Engine, we need to convert them using the prefab converter. Open it from window, boxophobic, the Vegetation Engine prefab converter. The prefab converter simplifies the conversion process with just one click. Let's select a prefab such as a tree. It is automatically detected in the converter. Now choose the conversion preset. For example, this tree made by Treat, a free software. Set the conversion option to the vegetation for trees. The conversion override option allows us to add or remove details, such as making the mesh readable or writable. Selecting share common materials will keep the material consistent for all prefabs with the same material. After pressing convert, you will see that the tree now has motion and has been successfully converted. The leaves are set as plant subsurface lit material and the bark as plant standard lit. In the main prefab folder, there is a new folder called prefabs data, containing backups of the original mesh, new materials and models. If you can't find the desired conversion preset, click the button at the top to link to a free package on the Unity Assets Store, providing access to all conversion presets. Now let's convert the grass, select all of them, and since we don't know the source of creation for this grass, choose automatic conversion, which we use when the prefab is using the Unity default shaders or custom shaders. While not guaranteed to work, but in most cases they work with some additional adjustments. Also, I have included a tree from SP3. Let's convert that too. Each shader comes with hundreds of settings that I won't be able to cover in this video, but the documentation provides very well explanations. Take for instance the motion settings. If I modify the motion bending, you will observe that leaves bend more than bark. There is a material manager that simplifies material settings. It detects materials in the selected prefab and allows us to choose a preset, and also we can select the which parts of the shader we want to edit. I select the motion settings. By changing values from here, we ensure that all materials such as bark and leaves are changed in the same way. Of course, we have the ability to save the current settings to a preset, making it easier for future use. Now let's take control of the seasons. Navigate to Global Control, where you will find Seasons Control, which isn't functional for now. I will explain that shortly. There is also Global Color, Global Alpha for controlling the leaves amount, and Global Overlay, which influences the color of our vegetation, enabling effects like snow. Moreover, we can access each individual material to adjust the Global Overlay or other values. Global color modifies vegetation colors. As mentioned, season control isn't operational yet, and to activate it, we need to connect it to an element. Right click, go to boxophobic, the vegetation engine, and add an element. By default, it creates a color element. You can modify the color or size. To hide the element texture, either drag it to the bottom of the ground or in the global volume, set the element visibility to always hide. This element is rendered inside the global volume. If the render is smaller than element, it won't be rendered. There are various elements with different functionalities, which we will explore later. In this color element, there is a render mode set to constant, but we can switch it to seasons to control each season's color. Adjust the seasons control and now it's working. Keep in mind that these elements can interact and mask each other, offering a wide range of possibilities to create scenes. For other elements like motion interaction, there are demo scenes that you can check out. The motion advanced has more settings to change the motion for the element. Look at this interaction element, it will use motion like a train. Vertex size fade element will change the size fade for our vegetation. These elements, along with the others, are explained in the documentation. As I mentioned, there is a lot to cover, and I can't show the all details in this video. This asset also includes other modules that provide additional tools and extensions to address various aspects, including Amplify Imposter, Train Shader, Blanket Shader, and more. Thanks to the developer, I will be showcasing these modules in the next video. Don't forget to like and subscribe to stay updated on the latest tutorials and tips. Thanks for watching and see you next time.